Welcome to the first lesson on version 1 of the critical path algorithm. In this lesson, we'll apply version 1 of the critical path algorithm to create a priority list. In our next lesson, we'll create a priority list and a schedule. A sequence of tasks in the digraph is called a path. A critical path dictates the minimum completion time or critical time for a schedule. As a result, it makes sense to consider the critical path when creating our schedule. The critical path algorithm allows the creation of a priority list based upon the idea of critical paths. And here are the steps for version 1 of the critical path algorithm. Step 1, find the critical path. Step 2, the first task in the critical path gets added to the priority list. Step 3, we remove that task from the digraph. Step 4, we repeat the process, finding the new critical path with the revised digraph. Let's take a look at our example. Again, our goal here is to find the priority list using the critical path algorithm. So to begin, we want to find the critical path starting at tasks 1, 2, or 3 that take the most time to reach the end. So for example, if we start at task 1 and go from task 1 to 4 to 7 to the end, notice how the total time would be 8 plus 10 plus 5, or 23 hours. If this is a critical path, there's no path that would take longer than 23 hours. Notice how if we start at task 1 again and go from task 1 to 5 to 8 to the end, the total time would be 8 plus 6 plus 9, which is also 23 hours. So if this ends up being the longest time, these would both be critical paths, but in either case, notice how we would add task 1 to the priority list. So let's go and just keep one of them for right now. Let's try some different paths from task 2 and 3. And again, we're looking for a path that has a total time of more than 23 hours. So from task 2 to 4 to 7 to the end has a total time of 2 plus 10 plus 5. That's only 17 hours, not more than 23. If we go from 2 to 5 to 8 to the end, total time would be 2 plus 6 plus 9, or 17 hours. Not more than 23. If we go from 2 to 6 to 8 to the end, total time 2 plus 5 plus 9, 16, less than 23. Again from 2 to 6 to 9 to the end, total time is only 9 hours, not more than 23. Let's try from task 3. So you can see this is kind of a trial and error process. From task 3 to 6 to 8 to the end, total time 5 plus 5 plus 9, that's 19, less than 23. And the last possibility, from task 3 to 6 to 9 to the end, that's only 12 hours. So because this is a critical path, we now add the first task, or task 1, to the priority list. Let's also record the total time for the path, just to keep track. And now we eliminate task 1 from the digraph, and repeat. Now the critical path would have to start from task 2 or task 3. So we're looking for the longest path starting from either of these two tasks. When doing this, it helps to have a good memory. The path from task 3 to 6 to 8 to the end had a total time of 5 plus 5 plus 9, or 19 hours. So let's record that and see if we can find a path that takes longer. From 3 to 6 to 9 to the end, again, has a total time of 12 hours. And starting at task 2, from 2 to 6 to 8 to the end would have a total time of 2 plus 5 plus 9. That's 16, less than 19. And from 2 to 5 to 8 to the end has a total time of 2 plus 6 plus 9, or 17, still less than 19. So this is a new critical path, so now we add task 3 to the priority list. Again, this path took a total of 19 hours. And now we eliminate task 3 from the digraph. And now we find the critical path again. Looking at the digraph, though, we can tell it is going to start at task 2. Let's go ahead and take the time and find the path. It would be the path from task 2 to 5 to 8 to the end. has a total time of 2 plus 6 plus 9, or 17 hours. There's no other path that would be longer. So we'll add task 2 to the priority list. Let's record the total time, 17 hours. And now we eliminate task 2 from the digraph. And now we look for the critical path again, which would begin at either task 4, 5, or 6. Notice the path from task 4 to 5 to the end takes a total of 15 hours. Let's see if we can find a path that's greater than or equal to 15 hours. Notice how the path from task 5 to 8 to the end also takes 15 hours. And if we try paths from task 6, notice from 6 to 8 to the end only takes 14 hours, and from 6 to 9 to the end only takes 7 hours. So we have two critical paths, and they start at two different vertices. So in this case, we need to add task 4 and task 5 to the priority list, and the order doesn't really matter, but typically we put the task with the lowest number first. So let's put task 4 followed by task 5. And again, both of these created paths with a total time of 15 hours. So now we eliminate both task 4 and 5 from the digraph. And now we find the critical path for this digraph. Notice how the path from 7 to the end only has 5 hours, so it does make sense that the critical path would have to start at task 6, which takes 5 hours as well. So if we start at task 6 and go to task 8, 6 to 8 to the end, had a total time of 14 hours. There's no other path longer. Notice how from 6 to 9 to the end only takes 7 hours. So this is the new critical path, and therefore we add task 6 to the priority list, which again gave us a path of 14 hours. And now we eliminate task 6 from the digraph. From here it's pretty straightforward. Task 8 takes 9 hours, task 7 takes 5, and task 9 takes 2 hours. So the remaining priority list would be task 8, task 7, and task 9. Again, the times would be 9, 5, and 2. Now that we have this new priority list, we could find a schedule using the list processing algorithm. So after doing this, you can probably see why there's a version 2. Version 1 takes a lot of trial and error, and as there are more and more tasks, this obviously gets more complicated. Version 2 of the critical path algorithm uses a process called the backflow algorithm. I hope you found this helpful.